As we've mentioned earlier a couple of times, when we install Pi, we suggest that you set it to auto-start so that it automatically starts up every time the operating system starts. But there are other ways to start up Pi and also to shut down Pi. You can use this Pi SRV start.bat to start up Pi when the operating system is not currently running. In fact, there are some times, like after an upgrade, for example, where that's exactly how you would want to start it up. There's no reason to reboot the operating system simply because you want to start up Pi. Now, what you'll notice is that Pi SRV start.bat, that in turn calls an Pi SRV site start.bat. And Pi SRV site start.bat is where we put those things that are site specific, like, for example, interfaces that are unique to running on that particular computer. So that file, Pi SRV site start.bat, that can in fact be used just to start up interfaces if you need that. Now, to stop Pi, we have a Pi SRV stop.bat, which in turn calls a Pi SRV site stop.bat. We do suggest that before you power down your computer, before you stop the operating system, just shut down Windows, you always run Pi SRV stop.bat so that Pi does shut down and shut down properly. Now, this has to do with how Windows shuts down processes. There's a certain timeout involved. And if it takes longer than, I believe it's 90 seconds or 2 minutes or so, then Windows just unceremoniously kind of shuts that process down, whether it has saved all its intermediate files or closed out all of its cache items or not. So that's why we think it's very important. Very important to emphasize you run Pi SRV stop.bat when you do want to shut down the operating system. So make sure Pi is shut down before you shut down the operating system. Now take a look in the Pi directory and you'll notice one more batch file that you could use. This is in the Pi/ADM directory. It's called simply Pi start. So here is the Pi SRV start.bat. Here's Pi SRV stop.bat. And then there's this Pi start.bat. That's simply used for debugging purposes. We suggest that you don't run that unless you're, well, trying to startup Pi what we would call interactively instead of as a service. By an interactive startup, that means that it's going to start up in a series of windows, and those windows might be a little bit more useful for troubleshooting because the standard output that's going to those windows is it's going to show you everything that's encountered by that application, even things that we might not think to write into the message log. Occasionally it will be a good diagnostic tool. However, starting up Pi using Pi start.bat, it's really about the only time you would ever do that is when you're working with tech support and doing some serious troubleshooting. So, in fact, some of our field service guys have been known to rename this Pi start underscore never run this dot bat because it really isn't something you would normally run in the course of normal operations with Pi. Oh, and one more thing about starting up Pi when you use Pi SRV start.bat is on a large server, it can take up to 30 minutes for Pi to start, so don't be surprised if it takes a little while for things like the different utilities or client applications to respond. As I mentioned in the last segment, there are basically two ways of starting up Pi. The automatic way, just when Windows reboots, or when you run Pi SRV start.bat. Now, either way, you want to make sure that when you start up Pi, exactly the same set of applications start up. So what we're suggesting is these interfaces that you're going to be installing on your Pi server, that you want to make sure that those interfaces are configured properly so that they start up properly no matter which method you use to start up Pi, whether it's rebooting or running Pi SRV start. Now, the way we do this is if you do have a new interface, so for example, let's say you're running the TCP response interface or the OPC interface that you see right here. Now, those are two interfaces that are not standard. So on the Pi server that you see pictured right here, on this Pi server, we're running, in addition to the regular interfaces, some additional interfaces, and we simply want to make sure that those interfaces, like, for example, these interfaces you see right here, that they are started up in the operating system and also in the PySRV site start.bat. Now that does mean you're going to have to edit this PySRV site start.bat and put in all those interfaces that are site specific. And at the same time you're doing that, you should edit PySRV site stop.bat to make sure that when you stop Py, we stop those interfaces as well. So simply put, no matter how you start up Py, whether it's by rebooting the operating system or running PySRV start, you want to make sure that all those things that normally start up with that server do start up, regardless of how you're, what method you use for starting up Py.